Good morning, children. In the last class, we have completed first chapter, that is nutrition in plants. Today, I will discuss exercise of that chapter, that is exercise of first chapter, that is nutrition in plants. I already sent question and answers of nutrition in plants chapter in the group, but some students are having doubt about the question and answer. That's why I will discuss once again with you all the question answers in the exercise. First, all of you open your textbook and fair book, and I will discuss question answers one by one. You go through that and check your answers. Okay, first question in the exercise. Why do organisms take food? Okay, you are following. Why do organisms take food? The organisms need to take food to build their bodies, to grow, to repair damaged part of their bodies, and to obtain the energy to carry out life processes. Second point, food provide resistance to fight against diseases and protection from different infections. This is the answer of first question in the exercise. Yes. Second question in the exercise is, distinguish between a parasite and saprotroph. For that, you have to make two columns and you have to write what is the meaning of parasite and what is the meaning of saprophyte with example. Parasites live on host plant and get food from host plant. Example, Cuscuta. Saprotrophs obtain nutrients from dead and decaying matter. Example, fungi, mushroom. Next, third question, how do you test the presence of starch? For that, you have to write iodine test. I will read the answers. Take two potted plants of the same kind, keep one in the dark for 72 hours and other in the sunlight. Perform the iodine test with the leaves of both the plants. Iodine test. Put iodine solution on the leaf. Observation. Blue-black color will be observed on the leaves of the plant kept in sunlight, which indicates the presence of starch. Blue-black color will not be observed on the leaves of plant kept in the dark room. This indicates the absence of starch. Next, fourth question. Give a brief description of the process of synthesis of food in green plants. You have to write the answer in point wise. Water and minerals present in the soil are absorbed by the roots and transported to the leaves. Carbon dioxide from the air is taken in through the tiny pores present on the surface of the leaves, that is called stomata. The leaves of a plant have a green pigment chlorophyll. It helps the leaf to capture the energy of sunlight. This energy is used to synthesize food from carbon dioxide and water. This process of synthesis of food in the presence of sunlight is called photosynthesis. Then you have to write the equation of photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide plus water and put aroma on that sunlight. Below that you write chlorophyll and carbohydrate plus oxygen. Then you have to draw the diagram. Which diagram you have to draw in the page, textbook you have to see. That textbook page number 3. This diagram. Okay, this diagram. Diagram showing photosynthesis. This diagram you have to draw in the fair book for the same question. Which question? Fourth question. Okay. Understood? Fourth question. Next, fifth question. show with the help of a sketch that plants are the ultimate sources of food. Fifth question, show with the help of a sketch that plants are the ultimate sources of food. You have to write plants are the ultimate sources of food and you have to show schematic representation like this. Fifth question answer, it is a fifth question answer. Sunlight is absorbed by the plants, autotrophs, and that should be eaten by heterotrophs, and both the plants and animals will die. They are decomposed by decomposers and then it will be added to the soil. These nutrients are again absorbed by the plants with the help of roots. This is a schematic representation to show the plants are the ultimate sources of food. Next, we have to discuss next question, fill in the blanks. Green plants are called autotrophs since they synthesize their own food. In the fill in the blank place, you have to fill autotrophs. Sixth one, B question, the food synthesized by plants is stored as starch. Answer is starch. C, in photosynthesis, solar energy is absorbed by the pigment called chlorophyll. Answer is chlorophyll. D, during photosynthesis, plants take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen gas. Next, seventh question, name the following. A parasite plant with yellow, slender and branched stem is called cuscuta or cuscuta. Another name for that, amarbel. You can write any one. Second one, a plant that is partially autotrophic, that is pitcher plant or insectivorous plant. Next, the pores through which leaves exchange gases, that is stomata. Next, eighth one, tick the correct answer. Cuscuta is an example of parasite. Answer is parasite. B, the plant which traps and feeds on insect is pitcher plant. Answer is pitcher plant. Next, mark the following. Column 1, chlorophyll. Answer is leaf. In front of that only you have to write. In front of chlorophyll, you have to write leaf. Nitrogen, rhizobium. Nitrogen, rhizobium bacteria helps in nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen, rhizobium. Cuscuta, that is parasite. Answer is parasite. Animals. Heterotrophs. Animals are heterotrophs. Insects. Example, pitcher plant. It is an insectivorous plant. Pitcher plant. Mark true if the statement is true and F if it is false. Carbon dioxide is released during photosynthesis. False. Because carbon dioxide is taken inside the leaf during photosynthesis. And oxygen gas is released during the photosynthesis. The second one, plants which synthesize their food are called saprotrophs. False. They are called as autotrophs. Synthesize their food are called autotrophs. Now, saprotrophs, they obtain nutrients from dead and decaying matter. That is also false. Next, third one, the product of photosynthesis is not a protein. Okay, yes, correct. No, if it is protein, then it will be false. Then not a protein they have given, that's why it is correct. Answer is true. Solar energy is converted into chemical energy during this process, during photosynthesis. That is true. You know that one. Solar energy is converted into chemical energy during the photosynthesis. Answer is true. First one is false, second one is false, third one is true, fourth one is true. Next, 11th question. Choose the correct option from the following. Which part of the plant takes in carbon dioxide from the air for photosynthesis. Answer is stomata. They have given options here: root hair, stomata, leaf veins, petals. Answer is stomata. Next, 12th one. Choose the correct option from the following. Plants take carbon dioxide from the atmosphere mainly through their leaves. Mainly through the leaves. I think answer is clear. 11th one answer is stomata. 12th one answer is leaves. And last question, that is, why do farmers grow many fruits and vegetable crops inside the large greenhouses? What are the advantages to the farmers? 13th question, last question in the exercise. Answer for that question. Fruits and vegetable crops are grown in large greenhouses because it protects crops from external climatic condition and to provide suitable temperature for the growth of crops. Advantages to farmers while growing fruits and vegetable crops inside greenhouse are: it protects crop from diseases and adverse climatic condition. It protects crops from wind and animals, rodents means rat, like that example. These are the question answers related to the exercise. If you have any doubt on this exercise, you can ask. And you have to write all these question answers in the fair book. And what I have given extra questions daily after watching the video, you are writing some question answers. No, I will give that questions. That also you have to write in the fair book. Extra question as well as this exercise question answers. All you have to write in the fair book. Some extended learning activities and projects they have given. You go through that project and activity and try to make that one. No need to write that in the Facebook or any practical book. Only you go through that and try to practice in daily life. And another one thing I want to tell. In practical book, I told you to write only the section of leaf. Section of leaf, structure of leaf, and structure of stomata. Only three you have to write. For that explanation, I will give in the next class or in the group, I will send the explanation what you have to write for the practical book. I think all the question answers are clear now. Some students are having doubt about that. Homework question, they confused with homework question as well as exercise question answers. Okay? Okay, thank you. If you have any doubt, you can call. Thank you.